So, as we continue to move forward, sometimes have setbacks.
And that's okay, because once you learn from that setback, learning what set you back to begin with,
you can now proceed forward again.
Now that I made that crazy little metaphor, let's start the show. We're gonna start on this and see where we get to today.
The estimated wait time is approximately
enjoyed the boring, however, this is the final project.
Fury Beats.
Now, I'm not completely finished, per se. Still got a few little odds and ends I plan to address here. I'm going to add a few extra little legs for the pothos to lay on top, just like this plastic right here. I'm just going to let this settle in for a day or two before I wish to tackle and add some more stuff to this. Right now, this is, you know, the priority, and make sure this thing works right. And after we get good and know our adjustments and our levels, we're gonna, you know, tighten this down a little bit more and get these out of the way. That's where we're at on that. This is just a handful of those fry. I'm not joking. I mean, as soon as I put this up, they were, everything was just going up into the, inverted aquarium. I'm gonna call this the attic, I guess. I don't know. We'll see. Before I forget, which I tend to do a lot, I'm going to try to explain the materials I ended up using. This old speaker wire that I had, never even used it. It was still brand new in the package. And the moment I went to go and wrap it around, it just felt weak, gave it a tug, and she ripped right in half. After I snapped it, I knew it wasn't worth using. So I ended up having to go into Plan B, which I had no clue at that time. And eventually I came to thinking about some of this old mule tape that I had. This is a nylon, okay, and this is about 2,000 pounds strong. Yes, figured it was gonna do good for wrapping around this aquarium, especially that I got extra and I wasn't using it all, you know. And yeah, that's what I did. Use what you got method in this one, definitely. Ah, the use what you got method. Sometimes a hit and miss.
That's what we do here.
We create challenges for ourselves
and to overcome them.
In this case, we did with this lacing wire. I've done this before on my hex tank, you know, this free suspension inverted aquarium. And that's pretty much what I went with, except the only change this time is I had to use mule tape because I didn't have any other stronger wire at this moment besides lacing wire. And I was not going to use exposed wire to wrap around the corners of glass and put pressure on it. That's just a no-no in all sorts of ways. Cushion strong material like I'm doing right here. And this is how it's all working together. You know, it's pushing down, which is also pulling up right here. And also for the lacing wires that it rests on. It's basically a selfless free suspension inverted aquarium. And that's what I did. And now for an upgraded viewing. And that's where we're at on that.
Oh, and catch you on the next flip-flop, too.
Thank you.